improv.
And you improvise specifically. You have a specific style of directing with improvisation. You have a megaphone, if I'm not mistaken.
Early on, I did not. Anchorman, Taladaga Nights, and Step Brothers, I did not have a microphone.
Okay.
I would actually yell it out, where I would run to the side of the camera, which I don't know why it took
me. Good for the pipes.
Not good for the pipes.
Would you leave really hoarse?
Yeah, sometimes. Okay. And I don't know what the hell I was thinking that I never thought to grab a microphone. And then, yeah, I think it was other guys is where I thought, wait a minute, give me a microphone. I don't have to yell. I can keep it soft. But yeah, the whole idea is we do the written scene 3 or 4 times.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we beat up our scripts. We rewrite them over and over and over again. We do a read-through, and we want it to kill at the read-through. And then we go and shoot the movie. And even though we have this script that's been great, we go, okay, let's get 3 or 4 takes as written, and then now let's play the game that we can get it even better. And so it'll usually be a back and forth with Will having an idea, and then I'll say something to him, or what if you said this line? So it becomes this conversation while we're rolling. You know, hey, I kind of liked what you were doing when you got really mad at that one moment. Expand on that a little bit. And then Dave, if he's going to get mad on there, you love him, so you're going to back off right away. See what happens with that. And then they'll play with it. I go, that's kind of nice, but can you sharpen this line? What if you said something like this? Or Will is saying back to me, wait, what if I did this and this? And then sometimes we're not even talking back and forth. Sometimes we're just rolling and we're finding it as we're rolling and I'm giving like one word directions.
Is that your favorite part of directing?
That's like, so much fun. So much fun. Yeah. And you know, we're professionals, but let's face it, the entire goal is I'm trying to make them laugh. I mean, that's the whole goal.
And then how do you know when you're done? I mean, you have all this stuff. How do you know what's going to make it in the edit?
So then our editor, this guy Brent White, has this amazing cataloging system for all the improv. And, you know, we usually shoot like 1 million feet of film on these movies. There's a lot of improv. Although we've gotten smarter through the years. We don't do quite as much when it's obvious we won't use it. But he has this cataloging system. And it's like for each scene, there's little subheadings of like the names of the riffs. And he can just click on them and it'll show them to you and he'll have his assistant editors edit them. So there's these little options. So then as we test the movie, we're constantly flipping stuff in and out and going, oh, wait a minute, try that there. You know what? I actually don't like that beat. Take that other riff we did and put that in there. And so you test the movie like 4 or 5 times and you're just always rotating in and out, rotating in and out from all the improv.
Improv.
Improv.